Welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallett, and today we're going to look at PowerShell and formatting the output in colour, putting a little bit of colour into our life. More importantly, we'll be looking at using some if constraints and for each. And as always, you'll be able to find these videos on theurbanpenguin.com. If you're on Twitter, you can follow me at theurbanpenguin. And on Facebook, you'll be able to find and like my page as The Urban Penguin. We need now to look at how we can use scripting within PowerShell so we can start making some use of modules and PS1 files so they're really working for us rather than us working around the shell. So you can see I've got my PowerShell prompt open and I'm in my home directory. I've logged in as a standard user and we're just going to look at returning some basic information. So if I use things like get service, we can see that we have the services that are currently configured on the system. Some are running and some are stopped. Everything in PowerShell is being returned as an object, so I can always retrieve those object properties. I can also feed them through to a variable. So I could have something like this, $allServices, and then we'll have that equal the output of getService. And then if I look at $allServices, we can see the output. So it'd be very easy for me to feed this information into a variable within a module and then read the values back. When we're writing to the screen, we could use write host. So if we want to pull out information from that variable, we could use write host. And of course, we can then just go hello or whatever we need. If we need to make it a little bit more visible, then we could use something like .foregroundColor, and we could set that to be magenta. So we can see then we get a different colour. And of course, we've got a range of colours that we can choose from. And you've just got to work out something that is going to be good for you. So we've got things like grey, which are then fairly bland, but fits in nicely to what we want. We've got then brighter colours such as yellow, more alert colours like red. And then of course we've got to be careful because if I use a colour like blue, we're not going to see it. But maybe something like cyan, we are still going to see it against the dark blue. And of course, if necessary, I could also change the background colour. Now, this really isn't going to look very pleasant when we write it purely at the command line, but it will give you an idea of some of the things that we can do. And then we'll look at putting this within our module. If I use for each and then set up what we're looking at, and here we can create a variable, we'll just call it $service. Let's just put that, it's not case sensitive, but it's easier for me to see. In all services, and then close the round bracket. We set up our brace brackets that are going to identify the block of code that we're going to do for anything that meets the for each condition. And then we're going to build up an if statement within the for each. So say writing it at the command line looks untidy, but it's going to be a lot easier once we put this within a script and use it as part of our module. We then have the test condition for the if statement, and we're going to look then at $svc.status. So remember why I said everything we're dealing with is an object. So then those objects have properties that we can look at. And then the condition we're going to have is equals and then stopped. Let's try and spell that correctly. Close our round bracket. And then we get into our brace bracket to describe what we're going to do if the if statement is evaluated as true. And then we can write host. And we're just scrolling across on the screen, so I'm just going to move across so we can see that happening. And then we're going to write $service.name, comma, $service.status. So we can see what's being written there, and we've just scrolled around. And then using the foreground color, and we'll have magenta for this. So that ends our condition, or our brace brackets, for the condition being stopped as far as the service is concerned. We're then going to have an else statement, and then we don't need a condition for this because we're just saying anything that's other than stopped. We're going to write host. We're going to write out to the host the service.name property, comma, the $service. So we're just listing properties that we want to print, service.status. And then the foreground color for this, we can then set to be cyan, or whatever we choose. That's the end of the brace brackets for the else statement. And don't forget that the for each statement also had its own brace bracket. So we've got two brace brackets that are closing at this point. As I say, if we're putting this within a script file, it becomes a lot easier where we can tab in. So it all just depends on how well we were typing at this stage. So let's give this a whirl. And then we see the output, and we can see now that it's been colorized based on our input. So if we are going to put this into a module, our modules are easily found by the system if we put them into our Documents folder, Windows PowerShell, and Modules, and then based on a folder that represents the module name. So here we are in my module, so my.psm1, and that's found in the my directory inside modules. As we saw before, we can then write simple functions, but obviously now we'll be looking at writing something a little bit more robust than we wrote before. We can have multiple functions within a single module. So here we'll create a function called get, and we might as well call it all services. That's as good a name as I can think at the moment. We must be careful with the verb names like get, set, new. Otherwise, we'll have errors when we import the module. We put our brace brackets to define then the code that makes up the function. And within the function, the first thing that we're going to do is create the variable. So remember, the first thing we did before outside of this was create a variable called all services, and that's going to be populated by the commandlet get service. Once we've populated that, we can then interrogate the variable for the status of those services, and we do that as we did from the command line with for each. And then the condition that we're looking at for the for each loop, so $service in $allServices. So we're creating a variable on the fly here called $service. All of that is contained, the conditions are contained within the round brackets, but then we need to open up a brace bracket to identify the code that we run for the for each loop. And we can see that putting it in some kind of IDE, here we're using Notepad++, but it's then much easier to have everything indented and to read the progress of the script. You can see now we're creating an if statement, as we did from the command line before, to look at the status field. And if it then equals a minus EQ stopped, we close the condition and open up our brace block that identifies the code that we do if this condition is true, i.e. if it is a service that is stopped. And then we'll write host, and again we're going to be writing the same sort of things as we did before, the service name and the service status. Remember, everything is an object that we've captured here, so we can refer to the properties of these objects. And we'll make sure that this is printed in magenta, so our foreground color being magenta. Outside of the if statement, we're now going to include an else block. So if it isn't stopped, then we meet this code bracket, and there's no condition that we need to put for this. And we can cut and paste then, and then we can just change this to be cyan if we keep to the color coding we used before. So of course it's a lot easier to work with within a text file than it is on the command line. Remember, a module to make use of it has to be imported, and the whole idea of having the module in the correct directory path is then that I can import it just by the module name. So we can then import module, and then the module name was my. That's a really good name, I know, but it works for me. When we hit enter on this, we're going to bring in then those two functions. And this was just my script associated with the module so we could see it loading. But now I can run get all services, and we should see our color coding as we had it before. So there we have it. We've now looked a little bit more at Windows PowerShell and the coding, how we can use colors, but I suppose more importantly, looking at the if statement and the for each statement. I hope it's been useful to you, and I certainly look forward to seeing you back on the Urban Penguin channel very soon.